This past weekend, Donald Trump lashed out at his own government, specifically the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, claiming that it was fake news that the United States this past Sunday had surpassed 350,000 COVID-19 deaths here on our soil. In fact, Trump tweeted out that he doesn't believe their numbers, and he said, when in doubt, call it COVID. Fake news. What he's suggesting here is that we haven't actually had 350,000 people die from COVID, which is a common claim among Republicans. No. It's just that every time somebody dies of something, we call it COVID. You know, if somebody had COVID and then they die in a car accident, we classify it as COVID. No, we don't, folks. We really, truly do not do that. But Republicans are also trying to say, well, this person had heart disease and they had COVID, but the heart disease is what got it. Yeah, because much like climate change, let's put it this way, it's a threat multiplier. It makes current situations that may not be fatal into fatal ones. Just like climate change makes hurricanes worse. Hurricanes are already bad as it is. But climate change comes along, creates conditions that make those hurricanes even deadlier. That's kind of what COVID does to these existing conditions, like heart conditions, diabetes, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD. Yeah, all of those things COVID can make worse. So yeah, cause of death would in fact be COVID-19. But here's why Trump does this. Obviously, this is his legacy. You know, the last year of his administration is nothing but COVID. And of course, all the, you know, potential crimes committed, but mostly COVID, right? I mean, this is what the guy's really going to be remembered for. There's a lot of things that happened during this administration that people have already forgotten about. Most people, honestly, up until this past week when he talked about impeaching him again, forgot he had even been impeached. Like, that's how quickly people move on from these things. But COVID, it took 12 months. It disrupted our way of life. It sent us into a recession. Tens of millions of jobs lost during this. It changed the way we live. He will forever be known for this. This isn't something he can escape. 350,000 dead Americans. We're talking about more than 100 9/11s. Yeah, he can't escape that. He can't whitewash that. And no matter how powerful the conservative media machine is, you know, the disinformation churning out from that nonstop, it's not going to change the fact that this is his legacy. People will not forget this, and it will forever be what defines the entire Trump presidency. And he deserves nothing less.